Steve Sandberg, spelled S-A-N-D-B-E-R-G. I'm the Chief Operating Officer and Locomotive Engineer on Steam Locomotive Number 261. It's an absolute joy. We had thousands and thousands of spectators that came out on the route today, all along the route. The Burlington Northern Santa Fe Railway did a great job of moving us over the railroad expeditiously. Everything was just a wonderful trip. The track was in great shape. I've been working on the 261 now for 20 years, and we just rebuilt the locomotive. And thanks to a lot of our railroad partners, like the Lake Superior Museum of Transportation and the Burlington Northern Santa Fe, we're able to share this with all the public and all the rail enthusiasts from all around the world here today. Well, first of all, the 261 was built in 1944, right at the peak of World War II. So it's an actual American hero. It was built to haul war troops in 1944. So the locomotive itself has been under overhaul for the last 4 years and just came out of service. And it's been now running for, this is its maiden voyage. So, well, this is the world's largest coal-fired steam locomotive. It's a little under 1 million pounds total weight. We carry 45,000 gallons of water with us, 33 tons of coal. Top speed is 90 miles an hour, and we can pull a mile-long freight train. Well, there was a lot of busy freight traffic out there today, and thankfully the Burlington Northern Santa Fe can fit us into their sensitive freight traffic. They had a lot of traffic between Minneapolis and Duluth today, so we always want our host railroad to make their trains on time, so we volunteered to just hold back a little bit and let them get through. No mechanical problems. Okay. No, engine ran perfect.
Okay.
So, no, I couldn't be more thrilled.
Okay, great, thank you.
Yep.
Here, I'll get this. Thanks for waiting, guys. We appreciate it.
Am I sufficiently dirty?
On behalf of the Board of Directors for the Lake Spear Railroad Museum and North Shore Scenic Railroad, we're welcoming Steve Sandberg, who's president of the Friends of 261 and the 261, and about 550 guest passengers from the Twin Cities that have arrived here for a weekend in Duluth. With me are some of the members of our Board of Directors. Our president is Neil Vanstrom. Representing the Canadian National Railway on the board is Jeff Castellano. This is Steve Sandberg, Friends of 261, and another board member, Scott Racine. Steve is the engineer that brought the engine in. As I said, he's also the president and executive director for the Friends of the 261, a nonprofit group that manages and cares for the engine over the years. And upon the arrival, this has been just rebuilt. I'll let Steve say a little bit about it and explain why we're here. We have a presentation to make at the end of the press conference.
Thank you very much. On behalf of the Friends of the 261 and railroad enthusiasts who've joined us from all over the world, from England, Germany, South Africa, Australia, New Zealand, and all over the United States, we're thrilled to be here in Duluth. This is a great day for railroad enthusiasts all over the world, and we'd like to make an initial contribution to the endowment fund for the museum in the amount of $10,000 to kick off a brand new fund for the museum and start them off on a new track, let's say.
Thank you for coming up here and on the inaugural run right here to Duluth. Beautiful weather as always, and we appreciate your contribution to our endowment fund. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Neil.
Thank you all for coming. If you have questions of Steve, he will be around for a few moments.